Hey guys, welcome back to my Save the Cat series where I am tackling the 15 beats in Save the Cat Writes a Novel. Today we're heading into beat number 9, which is the midpoint. If you missed any of the other videos, I created a playlist for you guys and it is linked below for you guys to check out. So what happens in the midpoint? This is the moment when your character either reaches a false defeat or a false victory, all while raising the stakes of the story. Like the book says, this is the middle of many things. It's the middle of the book, it's the middle of Act 2, and you're in the middle of your character's transformation. So let's start with a false victory. Why do we call it a false victory? Because we're in the middle of the novel. Your character is in the middle of a transformation. There's still a lot of story to be written, so you can't basically end the story in the middle of the book. So you're going to either give your character a false victory or a false defeat so that you can raise the stakes of the novel to take them into the rest of the book. Not to mention that your hero still hasn't learned the theme of the story. So what does a false victory look like? Maybe it looks like your character gets what they think will fix them, right? Without focusing on the big issue. And when you give them what you think they think will fix their problem, you are shining a light on the bigger problem. Remember, at this point, they are still flawed. They are still chasing the wrong thing. And in this moment is where they're going to get to see that, oh, I got what I want, but not so fast, right? That's that moment where you're gonna give them what they think they want, where they've reached this moment, but you as the writer and the reader will get a sense of like, oh my God, is this really it? Is this really happening? But you're really going to show that the victory was a false victory because the hero has not learned a theme, they have not fixed the bigger issues, and they're still chasing the wrong thing. One of the examples given in Save the Cat is in Me Before You. The midpoint is where Louisa thinks that everything is going seemingly well, right? She got her initial goal was to get a job, to help her family out. And she looks like she's doing well. She's succeeding. She's getting Will excited about life and, or at least going along with her, right? He's not as miserable as he was before. He even comes to her birthday party. So she's, this is in her eyes, she's winning, she's got a job, everything's working out great. But the true theme of the movie is that she, or the book, is that she needs to learn how to live life to the fullest. She has to take advantage of life and she's not doing that. So that's an example of a false victory. She thinks everything is going well because everything is going well with her initial goal of getting a job and getting paid. And then it moved on to Will and making him happy and making him, you know, like her in some way. But the truth of the matter is she still hasn't learned a theme. And that was a false victory midpoint. And a false defeat works much in the same way. You're going to show maybe your hero feeling like all it's lost, there's no point. And really what you're doing is you're focusing or you're shining a light on the bigger issues. You're going to show that she feels like this is over, but wait, there's more to come. There's more life to live. There's more book to read. There's something going to happen that it makes you feel like it's all over, but it really isn't. As writers, this is the moment that we need to take advantage of. This is the moment where we actually raise the stakes of the story. The author in Save the Cat says that this is the moment where she calls shit just got real. We're no longer in the fun and games, and it's time to get serious. Talking about your character, of course. So how exactly do you raise the stakes in a story? Well, maybe this is the moment where a couple shares a kiss they're not supposed to, or maybe there's a ticking bomb, or maybe there's a huge plot twist. There are many ways you can raise the stakes in the story, and you should have some idea of how you're going to do this before you even get to this point, honestly. That's why I am such a big fan of plotting your novel, because if you know exactly what it is that you're going to do before you sit down to write, by the time you actually sit down to write, everything comes to you easily. And you're not so stuck to the plot. Trust me, you're not so stuck to your outline. When you outline, you're not stuck, you know? Don't be afraid of outlining. You can move in and out of your outline if it doesn't work for you. This is why I'm such a big fan of outlining. By the time I get to that part in my novel, inserting what I want becomes so much easier. And if along the way I think of an even bigger stake than I thought when I first started outlining, then I'll just do that. I know that a lot of people are afraid of outlining because they feel it there is too rigid, or it blocks their creativity, or it doesn't flow with them, and they're afraid that whatever they've outlined, they're gonna have to stick to. That's not true at all. It just gives you a base from which you can write your story. If along the way you think of bigger and better things, then go with it. You don't have to stick to your outline. I know that I've done that before. I've outlined for Between Us, and my initial outline compared to what the novel is now is completely different. I wasn't afraid of switching things around, but it did make things so much easier when I sat down to write, knowing which direction I was going in. To sum up, the midpoint changes the direction of your story. This is almost like another catalyst. After this midpoint, you are making sure that your character is at the point of no return. They can no longer return to the first half of the second act because things are now changed. The stakes are raised. Something new has happened, and they can no longer go back to that. They have to keep going forward, and now in a new and hopefully better way. All right, you guys, that is it for the midpoint. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, make sure that you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you share it with all your writerly friends. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, I would really appreciate it if you did, so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. For the entire month of November, I will be uploading a video every other day until the last day of the month, after we've gone through all 15 beats. I hope that you are enjoying this series so far. I'll see you guys again in a brand new video in a couple days. Until next time, stay safe.